We'd like to, on behalf of the Glennon family, like to welcome you here, and the Reppert family, excuse me. It's kind of hard, I have that name to carry here today. Introduce the wedding party. Before doing that, I think Rita would like me to introduce one special person. I think this person's been called all day long the nobody. She's not been on the roster, but I tell you, she's kept everything together. She directed the show of the century. And I think one of the greatest things I've ever seen in my sister's life, I always was the groom. All our lives, we played wedding and family, and I always was the groom. Well, today I was the father of the bride. And Dad, I enjoyed it. And well, this lady, I met her, and she came all the way from North Carolina. And she's great. She's standing right back there. Her name is Vicki Pennington. I think y'all give her applause. She's also Rita's boss, I think, or supervisor. So I think I guess you got to bring the boss with you to get everything done.
Of course, she's the supervisor.
Supervisor. Okay, another gal from North Carolina was Mrs. Gina Quinn, and she's being escorted by Bob Glenn. Bear with me at this, I just got asked to do this about 15 minutes before I got to come into the building. So, another one of the girls that was working with Rita down in North Carolina was Miss Carolyn Holt, and she's being escorted by Tom Lauer. Sister, and she's being escorted by her husband Truman. This is Mr. and Mrs. Truman Langley. That's a close friend of Rita's. She's from the area. Mrs. Dorothy Stice, and she's being escorted by Jim Harkin. Bridesmaids, and still she didn't get to move up. but instead of the wooden horse, she got a real escort. His name's Ray, so it's Mr. and Mrs. Ray Hatt. Is at the front door there. One of them kind of bears a fantastic resemblance to me. She's gorgeous. Is Melissa Glennon. And the other one that bears a fantastic resemblance to her father and is also gorgeous is Megan Pat, the nieces of the a it's kind of rough for me to be doing this because this guy here is with his best man. I heard does the same thing that Jim does, and I'm sure after this is all over with, I'll probably be critiqued and dubbed out of the video completely. So they're going to play games with this on. So and the best man is Mr. Richard Underwood, and the maid of honor is Evelyn Mackey. There we have the two, the ring bearer is, get down here, Michael Husenthal, and Amanda Glennon, my little daughter. Next is the mother of the bride, and I did know this, but the groom.
Good. Yeah, you knew it. You knew it.
Edit.
Edit. Take two.
And the mother of the groom is Mrs. Bernie Reppert. Bernie. Now, please, welcome with me Mr. and Mrs. James Reppert.
I have them written down, so I graded you, so you can grade me, okay?
I'll grade you.
Thank you. Now, this whole the whole wedding and all weddings have, they all have to do with love. And the love that two people have for each other is the bond that transcends any problems that may arise. Now, believe it or not, I've come to know Jim and Rita very well, maybe more well than I wanted to. During the past years, And sometimes her problems of preparing for their wedding seemed almost insurmountable, especially getting him to the wedding. But the love that they have for each other would always rise above any problems that either one of them had, and they would always say to me, "Rich, I don't know if I can go through this, but I know one thing." Jim would say, "I love Rita," and Rita would say, "I love Jim." Ladies and gentlemen, would you please rise? And it gives me great pleasure to perform to propose a toast, not only to love, to happiness, but to the bride and groom, Rita and Jim.
Cheers.
Okay, why don't everybody remain standing, because I have one more. One more.
A baker's dozen.
Yeah, well, you get two for the price of one. Now, I had the opportunity this afternoon, after we took the pictures in 180 degree heat. Evelyn and I had the we both went to, we had the opportunity to go and visit Rita's father, who passed away recently. And this is a very special and happy occasion, but it's also kind of a sad one, because Rita's father, Paul, and Jim's father, Everett, neither one of them could be here today because they both passed away. But I am sure that they are looking down upon us all tonight, and their smiles are transcending throughout the heavens. I would like to perform a toast, and I don't want it to be a toast of sadness, but I want it to be a toast of happiness, because I know they are happy. Ladies and gentlemen, let's drink a toast to Everett and Paul.
Hear, hear.
Thank you.
She has.
Took a long time.
She said it took a long time. And Lord, I don't know Jim other than just to meet him, but I'm sure there are many who have loved him and stood with him over the years that he would find God's person. And Lord, it's just been so fulfilling today to watch this marriage take place. And I know that you're in it. And right now, Lord, we bring that blessing also upon this celebration and this fellowship together in Jesus' name. Lord, for a time for the families to be together, to get to know each other, for many people who haven't seen each other for years, to be together and renew and restore relationships. And we commit the whole time to you. Most of all, Jesus, we pray that your name at many tables will be lifted up and remembered for what you've done in the lives of these two people. We thank you for all of your provisions for this wonderful meal together. In your name, amen.
Amen.
Clang them one more time.
Okay.
Just tell us when.
Somebody in the back one.
Here goes one looking at me. And here goes one. Put it by your mouth and take a sip out and look at each other. Okay, good. Just like that.
You got the salad. Oh, man.
I give you a little kick to the
I'm making bubbles.
Good. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Sound Effect.
Aren't you going to sing your song now?
What's
more coming?
I hate potatoes.
You hate potatoes? How about salad?
I like salad.
You like salad? You like tomatoes?
No.
Just salad?
Yep. And these.
And those crunchy things? Croutons?
Take the potato. He doesn't like tomatoes.
There you go. Raymond?
You want your salad? Huh?
No, I need yes. Dinner!
Coming.
Melissa, did you want bread? You want bread? No? Salad? No? Maybe Judy will help you, okay?
Yeah.
Right in the face. Right, save that for later, huh?
Thank you, Dan.
Yeah. Okay, now we can have cake.
Hey, can we get chocolate?
It's marble.
Hey, wait a minute. We got
it. This is the best for later. Boy, she's getting lost already.
Already?
They're in position.
Seems so long.
yes. We call this group Threes of Crowd. We're here to have fun, and that's what we intend to do. Let's do some dancing right now. Let's get everybody out there on the dance floor and do a little something. Maybe we'll get you something we can tap your toes to when you get moving around. If my story is sad but true, it's by the girl that I once knew. She took my love and ran around like a single guy in town.
Yeah. Thank you.
state-of-the-art keyboard.